Okay, everybody, so welcome to today's lesson. We are going to be using our flat bead frame today to do some multiplication. Now, I know some of you have been able to go to school to pick up the materials to make this, and you watched the video where we talked about how to make it. If you haven't done that yet and you would like to, there are still supplies at school for you to go ahead and use. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a look at this bead frame. Down here, we have red zeros. This is called our list. Here, we have units, tens, hundreds, and thousands. And then up here, we can see our three families. We have simple, thousands, and millions. We have units of simple, tens of simple, hundreds of simple. Units of thousand, tens of thousand, hundreds of thousand. Units of million, tens of million, hundreds of million. Now our large bead frame stops right here, just stops at units of million, or it stops at units of million. So we can actually do numbers that are a little bit bigger on this frame. So I'm going to show you how we set up these problems. First, I'm going to write our problem over here. We're going to multiply 4,678 times 3. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to put a strip of paper here on my list, and I'm going to write the multiplicand on this strip of paper. Okay, I'm going to write the multiplicand on this strip of paper. So I have 8 units, I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to write 8 right under my units wire. So 8 units, 7 tens, I'm going to write it right under the tens wire. 6 hundredths and 4 thousandths. So I wrote each of the numbers in my multiplicand very carefully to make sure they line up with the wire, because if I wrote it like this, like it is close together on my paper, look, my numbers aren't going to line up with the wires correctly, and you're going to see why that matters in a second. So I have that stuff lined up. So I've done my multiplicand. And now I'm going to do my multiplier. And this is 3 units. So I'm going to put 3 on my unit stuff. Like this. And we're going to start multiplying units by units. So 8 times 3. What is 8 times 3? Well, 8 times 3, yes, is 24. So I'm going to show you how we put this on. We need 24. 2 tens, 4 units. See that? It even looks like the number 24, 2, 4, doesn't it? Okay, so 24. Now we need to do 3 times 7. What is 3 times 7? It's 21. So we're going to make 21. Picture 21 in your head. 21. And you bring it down. 3 times 6. What is 3 times 6? Well, that's 18. So let's pull it down. First, there we go, we can see our 18. Let me bring it down. Well, guess what? Look, we're out up here. We have 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000. So we need to exchange these 10 hundreds for 1,000. And then our last one is 3 times 4, which is 12. You can see that? There's the number 12, and we bring it down. There we go, that's it. We did a math problem. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 units, 3 tens, how many hundreds? 0, 4 thousandths, 1 10,000. Again, just because there's nothing written here doesn't mean that you don't have to write this. You need to include every single number on every single wire. So this says 14,034. Okay, let's do another one. And we're going to do 6, 9, 8, 7 times. I'm going to do times 4 this time. Okay, so I'm going to write my multiplicand on my strip of paper and make sure to line up the units with the units wire, tens with the tens wire, so on and so forth. So make sure they line up with your wires on your bead frame. And this time we're going to multiply by 4. So 4 times 7. What is 4 times 7? 4 times 7 is 28. Bring that down. Now we move on. 4 times 8. 32. 4 times 9. 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 36. And 4 times 6 is 24. 24. And there we have our answer. So we have 8 units, 4 tens, 9 hundreds, 7 thousands, and 2 ten thousands. So we have 27,948. Okay? Good. So the thing you want to watch out for, some tips and hints, is see, we had 4 times 7, we got 28. It's important that you don't skip the 8 and go to the 9. Just because there's something on this wire here doesn't mean this wire is done. We multiplied 4 times 7, now we have to do 4 times 8. Okay, so there's already 2 beads on here, but that wasn't from 4 times 8. That was from 4 times 7. Okay, so it's really important that you watch out for that. You don't accidentally skip any wires. Okay. Let's just do one more together. So we're going to multiply 5,629 times, we're going to do a big one, times 6. So I'm going to write my multiplication down, 9 units, 2 tens, 6 hundredths, 5 thousandths. And we're going to multiply this by 6. All right, here we go. Big time. 9 times 6. What is 9 times 6? That's going to be 54. 5 times 4 units. What I like about the flat bead frame is that it actually really does look like the number, you know, 56 in the right order that we would imagine 56 to look like. I find that to be very helpful. 2 times 6, or 6 times 2. Well, that's 12. So there's 12. Bring it down. You see, I'm always making the number before I bring it down. 6 times 6 is 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 36. Bring it down. And then 6 times 5. What is 6 times 5? Well, that's 30. So here's 30. So 3, 0. 30. There we go. Let's write down our answer. We have 4 units, 7 tens, 7 hundredths, 3 thousandths, and 3 ten thousandths. 33,774. Okay? So that's one-digit multiplication on flat bead frame. Okay, so we'll be doing two-digit and three-digit multiplication very soon. If this is the first time you've had this lesson and you are ready for it, I want you to make sure that you practice it. Okay, practice, practice, practice is important. Get used to the frame. Get used to things where you're exchanging. Okay, that exchanging is important. I don't know if you noticed, but I always brought down 36. I always brought down my tens first. Do that because you don't want to have, you know, say your answer was 42 and then you needed 36. You said, well, here's 6. Oh, I got to exchange. And then you only bring down 2 because you think there should be 3 there. 36, bring it down, and then see that you need to exchange. So you get a very different answer. Okay. All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Let me know if you need any help. I'm always here. Okay.